Hello everyone, in this tutorial we will focus on how to select accuracy metrics, activation and loss functions in classification problems. First, we will review the types of classification problems, activation and loss functions, label encodings and accuracy metrics. Furthermore, we will also discuss how the target encoding can affect the selection of activation and loss functions. Moreover, we will talk about how to select accuracy metric correctly. Then, for each type of classification problems, we will apply several activation and loss functions and observe their effects on performance. We will experiment with all these concepts by designing and evaluating a deep learning model by using transfer learning on horses and humans dataset. In the end, we will summarize the experiment results. I split the tutorial into three parts. In the first part, we will focus on binary classification. In the upcoming parts, we will focus on multi-class classification and multi-label classification. If you would like to learn more about deep learning with practical coding examples, please subscribe to my YouTube channel or follow my blog on Medium. Do not forget to turn on notifications so that you will be notified when new parts are uploaded. You can access this Colab notebook using the link given in the video description below. If you are ready, let's get started. Here are the references that I will use during this tutorial. Let's first talk about types of classification tasks. In general, there are three main types or categories for classification tasks in machine learning. The first one is binary classification for two target classes. The second one, multi-class classification, more than two exclusive targets. Only one class can be assigned to an input. The third one is multi-label classification. More than two non-exclusive targets, one input can be labeled with multiple target classes. If you need to give some examples for these classification types, binary classification is it cat or dog? So the answer is should be only one or zero. In multi-class classification, for example, which animal in that picture? So there could be many animals like dog, cats, and the other animals, but only one of them should be the answer. And in multi-label classification, for example, what are the animals in that picture? There could be more than one animal in that picture. So these are the examples for classification types. Types of label encoding. In general, we can use different encodings for true actual labels or Y true Y labels. A floating number, so in binary classification most we use it, so it could be 1.0 or 0.0 for cat or dog or human or horses, whatever the binary classification problem is. The other one is one-hot encoding. So in multi-class classification we can show the which class is the correct answer in one and all the wrong answers for each other classes are zero. And the third one is a vector of integers. So in multi-label classification, for example, we can provide the answers. So the 14, 225, and 3 are the correct classes or labels for the answer. We will cover all possible encodings in the following example. But before, we need to discuss about types of activation functions for classification tasks. In Keras, there are several activation functions. Below, I summarize two of them. The first one is sigmoid or logistic activation function. In sigmoid function, we map any input to an output ranging from 0 to 1. For small values, like smaller than minus 5, sigmoid returns a value very close to 0. And for large numbers, for example, greater than 5, the results of the function gets close to one value. Sigmoid is equivalent to a two element softmax. We are going to see softmax in a minute, where the second element is assumed to be zero. So there is a relation between sigmoid and softmax functions. Therefore, sigmoid is mostly used for binary classification. So the example is like that. Assume that your last layer of the model looks like that. So we have only one neuron because we have only one output like 0 point or 1 point. So activation is the sigmoid. So what happens actually in this layer? I would like to show you. Let's assume that the last layer has these outputs for the batch size. So assume that the batch size is here 5. So these are the 5 predictions from the last layer. So let's call this ypredlogit. These are just numbers. So by using the Keras activation sigmoid function, let's apply these and we are gonna print out these. So let's see the in the end the element summation of the all element values. So the numbers are these. So there are 5 numbers in the batch. So there are 5 predictions. And after the applying the sigmoid functions, you see that all the numbers are between 0 and 1. But if we put all these numbers together, the summation is not necessary to 1. It means that actually we are converting each of these numbers, given numbers, to some number between 0 and 1. But there is no relationship between these numbers. These are all distinct numbers, distinct predictions, each of them converted by the sigmoid element by element. But if you move on to softmax function, in softmax function, we convert a real vector to a vector of categorical probabilities. The elements that out of the vector in range, again 0 and 1, and sum of all these elements will be 1. Because this vector will be showing the probability distribution over the categories. Alright. Each vector is handled independently. So there are not only the scalar values, but we are talking about some vectors. Softmax is often used as the activation for the last layer of a classification network because the result could be interpreted as a probability distribution. Therefore, softmax is most used for multi-class or multi-label classification. So for example, assume that this is the last layer of the model here, and the last layer of the model has 3 neurons. So you see that we have 3 outputs in one vector, in the second vector another one. So you can assume that here is the batch size is 2. So we have 2 results for each batch. Now after applying the softmax function, we will see what happens. So here, when you say that dense layer activation softmax, so this gonna be happen. So we get the numbers from the last layer. We apply the softmax. Let's see here. So we have 3 results because we have the 3. So these are the actually first class, second class, and third class. You see that these are just ordinary numbers. By applying the softmax, we are converting these numbers into probability distributions. And if you sum up all these distributions here, you would see that it ends up with 1.0. For the second vector, it is 1.0. So in these examples, you see that the difference between sigmoid and the softmax. And as a last note, I would like to talk about that if you don't specify any activation by giving the none, so you can provide the activation here by the keyword none. No activation is applied to the outputs of the layer. So what happens? The numbers, ordinary numbers, comes out as a result. Okay, so it could be called linear activation. So whatever the last layer neurons has the value, it will be outputted. Now we are at a good point to discuss the loss functions for classification tasks. In Keras there are several loss functions. I summarize the ones used in classification tasks here. The first one is binary cross entropy. Computes the cross entropy between true labels and predicted labels. We use this cross entropy loss when there are only 2 label classes. So the name comes from here, binary cross entropy. Means that you are gonna use this cross entropy loss function when there are only 2 label classes, assumed to be 0 point or 1 point. For each example, there should be single floating point value per prediction. The second loss function, categorical cross entropy loss function. Compute the cross entropy loss between the labels and predictions. The use of this cross entropy loss function when there are two or more labels, and plus these labels must be in one hot representation. In this sparse categorical cross entropy, actually it is very closely related with categorical cross entropy. The only difference is that the labels provided in as integer numbers. So I will show the examples for these in the next part, but today we don't need to talk about sparse categorical cross entropy. So let me remind you some important notes about these. In Keras, these three cross entropy functions expect two inputs: the correct true actual labels, so whatever you like to name them, but they are the y true mostly called, and the predicted label, mostly we called y hat or y pred. As mentioned above, the correct actual labels can be encoded floating numbers, one hat, or array of integers. However, the predicted labels should be present as probability distribution mostly. If the predicted labels are not converted to probability distribution by the last layer, sometimes we can use the activation none, then we need to inform these three cross entropy functions by setting their from logits true. So I would like to explain this from logits true more. If the parameter from logits is set true in any cross entropy loss function, then function expects ordinary numbers as predicted label values and apply sigmoid transformation on these predicted labels to convert them into a probability distribution. For details, you can check the TF Keras backend binary cross entropy source code. Here I just copy paste a part of it. So it shows that if from logits, is true, then return sigmoid cross entropy with logits. So what it means that it basically applies the sigmoid function onto the ordinary numbers. Both categorical cross entropy and sparse cross entropy have the same loss function, which I mentioned above. The only difference is the format of the true labels. Remember that if the true labels are in one hot format, then we are going to use the categorical cross entropy. For example, for tree class classification, it could be 100, 010, 001. These are one hot encoded in tree class problem. So here, if correct actual labels are integers, we are going to use sparse categorical cross entropy. For example, if we provide the answer to the problem, this is one, the correct answer, this is the second class, this is the third class. So we are using the integers to represent the actual labels. The usage entirely depends how we load our data set. So one advantage of using sparse categorical cross entropy, it is that it saves storage in memory as well as time in computation, because it simply uses a single integer for a class rather than a whole one hot vector. Assume that there are 1000 class, then you are going to use 1000 dimensional vector to represent the one hot encoding of all these classes, but otherwise you just use one single number, integer number. Okay. Now let's talk about types of accuracy metrics. So Keras has several accuracy metrics as well. In classification, we can use two of them. The one is actually accuracy. This is the general definition, so we need to learn this. Calculates how often the predictions equal labels. So I will give you some example here. So assume that this is the y true. So the first answer is 1, the next one 1, the other 0 and 0. These are the binary class. Classification y true, and here is the predictions from the last layer. Here 0.99, 1.0, 0.01, 0.0. So when you compare by using the these two Y2 Y-pred by using the just the accuracy metric. It is just check by each number if they are equal or not. So when you compare this number with this number, you see the it is false. But if you compare 1 with 1.0, it is true. 0 with 0.1, it is false. And 0 with 0.0, true. So the accuracy becomes 0.5. Now we are gonna see the binary accuracy, which we mostly use in binary classification. So it calculates how often predictions match binary labels. The keyword is here binary labels and match, not equal, match, but not the labels, but the binary labels. So Y true are the binary labels. So it means that there should be other label as an option, which is the zero. And here we understand that these labels has the alternative to be 0 or 1. Okay. Now, the match means that if this is the true label, now what about the prediction? So we need to match this prediction with the true label. So basically we consider that 0.5 and less values means 0. So when you match this, you cannot match. So here you see that the result is 0, so it means that they are not equal. So if you try to match this, the second values, so 0.51 matches with 1, so you here see that 1. And here 0.5 actually means 0, less than 0.5, less or equal to 0.5 is 0. So you see that it matches. And here 0.51 does not match with 0, so 0. So the binary accuracy here 0.5. Alright. Now let's move on to the categorical accuracy. Calculates how often predictions match one hot labels. Now remember that before we are talking about binary labels for binary accuracy. Now for categorical accuracy we are talking about one hot labels. Don't forget, it's important. Now here in this example I assume that there are three classes exist. So according to these three classes we have one hot encoding. So the third class is correct here. Here the second class is correct here. So we need to again match these. So the match that all these vectors should match with these numbers or probabilities. Here we are talking about the numbers or probabilities. It doesn't make any difference because if the biggest number here, for example 0.9, means that this should be 1 but it fails 0. So you see that these two vectors does not match. Okay. And please pay attention that here is does not the total does not 1, so it's not a probability distribution. They are just numbers, but it doesn't make any difference. As I said, the largest number can define the predicted class. Okay, here let's check that this is the second class is correct in the Y true. Okay, if you check here, now here is they are the sum of these numbers does not make one, but still we are gonna select the largest one. So largest one is the match with the correct class. So we have the one match. So the accuracy will be 0.5. If you have some problem to remember, just remember that accuracy match the numbers exactly. So if they are motomot, so if they are equal or not. Binary accuracy, so takes care of the probabilities. If it is less than or equal to 0.5, it is 0. Or larger than 0.5, it is 1. So in the categorical accuracy, you need to remember that the Y true must be in one hot. Okay, so it must be one hot representation. That's the whole idea. Now let's get our example. So I will download and make ready the horses or humans dataset from the TensorFlow datasets. Here let me show that in this dataset labels, true labels are encoded with single floating number 1.0 or 0. So I will show you. Here I just download and the train and test data set. So you see here that we have this number of samples in train and test. So let me show you some examples. What you see is that these are the image shape and here is the label. So 0 label means that horse and 1 label means human being. Here I just resize and scale the image. As you see that now the image is 32x32 and the labels are still binary. Okay. I here prepare the data batch. So I set the batch size 64 samples. So we have this number of batches in train and test. Then I use the transfer learning by importing VGG16 here. So I will use the base model. And then using the base model, I create here the model. But notice here that here I use some initializer so that in my tests, the models begins with the same weights. That's the idea. Here we have the activation. It could be none or sigmoid or softmax. So you can select these. Here is the last layer. Notice that in the last layer we have only one neuron because remember our problem is binary classification problem and remember that our output, the predictions will be a single floating point number because remember that our true actual labels are encoded 1.0 or 0.0. So one neuron is enough to compare these. Here I provide the whatever the activation function. All right. Now remember that if you use the none here as an activation function, okay, in the last layer, we need to set the from logits true in cross entropy loss functions as discussed above. Thus, cross entropy loss functions will apply a sigmoid transformation on the predicted label values. Remember this code. So it will happen automatically. So let's compile the model. When you compile the model, you need the loss function. So here you see that we have the binary cross entropy loss function here with from logits true. Remember, here we set the none activation. So since there is no activations, we let the loss know that the results, the predictions are just ordinary numbers. They are not probability. So that's why we use it. Here, pay attention that we use the binary accuracy here, not just the accuracy. We have three kinds of accuracy. Most of the guys use this accuracy, just accuracy, but there is a problem. Let me explain that. Keras does not define a single accuracy metric, but several different ones. Remember, these are accuracy, binary accuracy, and categorical accuracy. What happens under the hood is that if you select mistakenly categorical cross entropy as your loss function in a binary classification, and if you do not specify a particular accuracy metric by just writing the metric accuracy, Keras wrongly infers that you are interested in categorical accuracy, and this is what it turns in the results, while in fact you are interested in binary accuracy since our problem is binary. To get model fit and the model evaluate run correctly without mixing the loss function and the classification problem at hand, we need to specify the accuracy metric correctly. If the true actual labels are encoded binary 0 or 1, you need to use the Keras matrix binary accuracy for measuring the accuracy since it calculates how often predictions match binary labels. So that's the very important thing. Here in matrix, do not just write accuracy. Because we are gonna see and try. If you can change this, the categorical accuracy, categorical cross entropy. Here just accuracy, then everything will be ruined. So please put the matrix here, binary accuracy, to ensure that your fit and evaluate will run correctly. Now, actually you can try by yourself changing this activation sigmoid softmax none and changing this binary cross entropy to categorical cross entropy with or without from logits true. And here, how I fit the model with the validation data set. I use the test data set for the validation. I run this 20 epochs. Each epoch almost takes 17 seconds. In the end, I tried all possible combinations of these activation loss here you see, and these are the accuracy results. So when you run this notebook, most probably you would not get the exact numbers here. Of course, you cannot get the exact, but rather you would observe very similar values due to the stochastic nature of artificial neural networks, I believe. Now I would like note several things if you care about here. The most successful ones are the non-binary cross entropy from legit true and the sigmoid binary cross entropy. Generally, we use softmax activation instead of sigmoid with the cross entropy loss value because softmax activation distributes the probability throughout each output node. But for binary classification, we use sigmoid rather than softmax. The practical reason is that softmax is especially designed for multi-class or multi-label classification tasks. Sigmoid is equivalent to two-element softmax, where the second element is assumed to be zero. Therefore, sigmoid is most used for binary classification. So these are the general rules. And the above result supports this. So you notice that the sigmoid has learn and get the 0.72 accuracy, but look, softmax cannot learn anything, so it's binary classification. As you see, the other options does not learn, these models cannot learn from the training, and in the testing they fail. You see, why does binary cross entropy loss function with from logit lead to a good accuracy without any activation function? Because using from logit true parameter tells to the binary cross entropy loss function to apply its own sigmoid transformation over the inputs, as we discussed above. Remember that if from logit true, then return an sigmoid layer cross entropy from logit. So that would be one reason. Second reason could be that in Keras documentation, it's written that using from logit true may be more numerically stable. So that would be another reason. Now we can conclude that if the task is a binary classification and true actual labels are encoded as single floating number 0 point or 1 point, we have two options to go. The first option, activation is sigmoid, loss is binary cross entropy, accuracy metric, of course, binary accuracy. And in the second option, activation is none, loss binary cross entropy, but from logit true, and accuracy metric always binary accuracy. Now, after discussing if the true label encoded 0 point or 1 point, just a floating number, now let's see that if we encode the label, with 1 hat, that is 10 or 01 for the horse and the human. So normally in binary classification problems, we don't use 1 hat encoding for Y true values. However, I would like to investigate the effects of doing so in your real life applications. It's up to you how to encode your true Y values. You can think of this section as an experiment. So first convert the true actual label encoding to 1 hat. Here you see some examples. Now for the horse, you see that 10 the label, and for the human the 01. So 1 hat encoding already done. So let me prepare this model, the same model. Now please pay attention for the model. Now we have the last layer. We have two units instead of one because we are gonna symbolize the 1 hat encoding with two classes. Remember that 1 hat actor has two floating point numbers in binary classification. For the last layer, the activation function could be none, sigmoid, softmax. And remember that When we select none is a activation function, we need to tell to the cross entropy function, whichever we are using, telling that from logits true. After compiling the model, it can run, but before the running, let me explain something. Here you see that we have the loss function here, right? But here we have the most important metric, categorical accuracy. Why? Because remember that categorical accuracy is specially designed for one-hot encoding the y-true labels. So you cannot apply here binary accuracy. Remember that we already discussed. The results I obtained from this experiment by changing the activation function, loss function, and here are the accuracy values. So what you notice first is that using activation function sigmoid with binary cross entropy loss, the accuracy is the highest one, with activation is selected none and loss binary cross entropy from logits true. So these two options produce the highest accuracy for our test. And the other options, other than the sparse category cross entropy, we cannot implement because the y's are not in integer format. So the others have the same exact value here. Remember that in the first one, first experiment when used the floating point, they also have the exact values, but just 0.5, so they couldn't learn from the training data anything. So the model is does not have any capacity to learn. But here we see that the rest of the models able to learn something here and very close to the best results. Okay. Now, if you let me, I would like to discuss a little bit these things. So first question could be that why do binary and categorical cross entropy loss functions lead to similar accuracy? You see that 0.71 and 0.69 are not so, does not have big. Now, I would like to remind you that when two loss functions are applied to the true labels that are encoded one hot, that's the important point. So we are applying the sigmoid and softmax to one hot encoded y true labels. The calculated loss values are very similar. You can try and see this. Thus, the model converges by using the loss function results. And since both functions generate similar loss functions, the resulting trained model would have similar accuracy as seen above. So that's my explanation for that table. So I couldn't find any supporting fact from the documents, but try with the sigmoid and the softmax on one-hot encoded data, you would come up with the same result. Second question could be why do sigmoid and softmax activation functions lead to a similar accuracy? Since we use one-hot encoding in true label encoding, sigmoid generates two floating numbers changing from 0 to 1. But the sum of these two numbers do not necessarily equal to 1. So they are not probability distributions as we've seen. On the other hand, softmax, we know that generates two floating numbers changing from 0 to 1, but the sum of these two numbers exactly equal to 1. Normally, the binary and cross binary and categorical cross entropy loss functions expect a probability distribution over the input values when from logit false as default. However, sigmoid activation function output is not a probability distribution over these two outputs. We know this. Even so, the binary and categorical cross entropy loss functions can consume sigmoid outputs and generate similar loss values. So you can try and see this. So there could be the last question, why this magic number here? So you notice that all the others than the best result have the same exactly accuracy and run this thing many times. So I have run the models for 20 epochs starting with the same initial weights to isolate the initial weight effects on the performance. Here four models achieve exactly the same number and the rest similarly achieve exactly this number. So one reason might be only by chance, but I don't believe this. Another reason could be if all the loss calculations end up with the same values, so that the gradients are exactly the same. So it's low in low probability, but it looks like that it happens. But it's not likely. I checked several times, but the process seems to be correct. Please try yourself at home. And if you have any explanation, you can write down to the discussions below. Comment section, I mean. According to the above experiments results, if the task is binary classification and the true actual labels are encoded as one hot, you might have two options. Option A, activation none, loss binary cross entropy from logist true, accuracy metric, categorical accuracy always because one hot encoded. Option B, activation is sigmoid, binary cross entropy loss, and accuracy metric, of course, categorical accuracy. Now, let me summary what we have done so far. So, in a nutshell, in binary classification, we use floating numbers 0, 1, 2, encode the class labels generally. Binary accuracy is the correct accuracy metric, is for sure. Generally recommended last letter activation function is sigmoid, and loss function is a binary cross entropy loss function. But in the above experiments, we observed that last layer activation function none and loss function is binary cross entropy from logits true parameter could also work. So the summary of the experiments are as on seen that table. So next part, I am going to work on multi-label classification. So there will be more than two target classes, 3, 4, 5. We are gonna see how to select the activation function and loss function along with accuracy metric. So if you like the video, please click like button. So please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.